guys. Sorry for that hang up with the tree. Another tramp. For any of you truckies out there, the start date is 12122018. Anybody that's not a truckie, it's December 12, 2018. And as you can tell by the trees, monster, and I decided to stay out because it's beautiful. It's really super damp, humidity 100%, but I don't know, up here when you get 8 months of winter, getting out and staying out means this is what you're doing. And you know what? Look at how flipping beautiful it is. On the Red River. Now, yesterday, I was walking on the river, and I mentioned how close I was getting to open water. Get up here. I'm hoping that there's a clearing, and I'll be able to exactly show you where on the river that I was walking and how close I was to that open water. All right, see if I can get you back in view. For this view, so I don't know how well I'm doing, but I know I'm not liking hiking my right on all these tree branches. My pack doesn't need to be this big. I went home and I started packing, and I thought, okay, stealth mission. Fucking excellent. And, this is the stuff that I was never allowed to do under contractual purposes. Formats, I guess, is a better word. I don't know. As you can tell, I'm not a very eloquent talker. I don't have the, vocabulary of a professor. But, you know what I'm saying. So, it's beautiful down here, man. Yeah, so I want to do a stealth camp. But here's the situation. If it's almost 2 o'clock, I've got 2 hours of daylight. Now, the city, which you probably can't see through this little camera, it doesn't matter, I can't see it either. We're socked in with fog and hoarfrost, which is beautiful. We got a bit of a wind. You can see here maybe in. We do have wind. It's forecasted to snow. I hope it does. Because winter camping is so much more beautiful and so much more warmer when it snows. But I do need to find a place to set up camp. I do need to collect wood for fire. I realized it last time that I was out. One article of kit that I couldn't find was my folding saw. Now, I'm not your ultralight backpacker, as you can fucking tell. Because I'm in Canada. And, we need more gear. We need more equipment. But I also do a lot of solo. I rely solely on myself. Therefore, I have an enlarged first aid kit. I don't have any allergies except for... What's that one? There's one drug. I don't know. It starts with an N. I have allergies too. But I carry EpiPen. What you're not allergic to in the city, how the fuck you might bump into something in the bush that you are allergic to. But never ran across it before. Saving my own ass is top priority. So therefore I come a little bit more equipped. I'm wearing a fleece shirt with a long sleeve base layer underneath. I'm trying to keep my temperature down. I don't want to start sweating. I've got a lot of fluid on board, about 35 pounds of it. My bag right now is weighing 60. It's probably about 55 pounds with the water. Take the water out, man. Let's see. Well, you'll see my kit as I'm setting up. But it's as light as I can possibly get away with for what I do. Anyways, so we're gonna go stealth camp. I gotta get my ass in gear because by the time I get in somewhere, I get set up, I get some firewood, and it's gonna get dark pretty quick. And I'm not in a hurry to get up and get going in the morning. I do have some grub, I do have my coffee. And stuff like that, so we'll find out here. So for now, I'm gonna hike this little trail with you over my shoulder. I'm gonna put you away. I'm gonna try to make some miles because I need to. And when you're carrying a camera, especially in a new position you've never done before. Thank you. golf camp. I'll certainly get you tuned back on before I pick a spot. I think it's important for you guys to see how I pick my spots, what I'm looking for, and we'll go through gear. Etc. For now, other champs, I'm gonna put you away here for a little bit, make some miles, and whatever's pretty, whatever's important, whatever's entertaining, I don't know. You'll be turned back in. Guys, I was just checking the time, and I didn't check the time. I stopped here, I had to get the pack off so that I could get some fluids out of the back of it, or out of it. It's 2:30 in the afternoon. My goal is to be somewhere by 3. That only leaves me another half hour. I don't mind cooking in the dark, but trying to set up in a decent place, gather your wood, stuff like that, all by headlamp. Trust me, I have done it a gazillion times, but if I can avoid that, I'm certainly going to try. I'm drinking Tang. Gives me bad fucking heartburn, but it also keeps my energy level up, keeps my sugars up, keeps me warm. You know, it's fuel for the furnace, and I hope I don't have to tell you all, I'm a firm hydration kind of guy. Check out my bag, eh? Look how old this sucker is. It's got no hip pockets. It's a pure mountaineering bag. Mount Rainier is the last time, this is the last ascent that this thing's ever seen. But I promise you, I just love this bag so much that I didn't have my binder done up. Fuck. Another rookiness. Where do I want this guy? I guess on this side. And it's not done up again. But I'm not worried about it. Anyways, I just love this bag. There's a single pocket here on the back, 10 liters. I got it in the middle right now. There's supposed to be, I have the other one. There's two extra 10 liters. So this is 120 liters plus 20. They don't make them this big anymore. And this bag pretty much goes with me everywhere. Because I'm either doing trips like this close to home, where I want the extra luxuries of clothing and stuff like that, or I'm going on multi-day trips and I need the extra room for extra food and whatever stuff like that. So, but anyways, we can talk about that shit later. Right now, wind's picking up, and I gotta go and find somewhere to camp. So, yeah, let's get on with it, eh? Hit her pad. Okay, guys, I found home for the night. I'm not so far down into the water, down by the water where the cold air will sink. Spit it out, man. And I'm not so high up. I got lots of protection from the wind, although there is a bit of a breeze, and I like that. This isn't my first choice. A really nice place all picked out, and then all of a sudden this guy comes walking his fucking dogs off leash. It's alright if they're little fucking goddamn chihuahuas. He's a great big fucking master for fucking something, man. And they're coming right at me, fucking growling, snarling. He doesn't give a fuck. He's just walking on. Fuck him. Fuck him. Anybody that has a dog like that, that you let run off leash, should be fucking trained to not run up and scare the fuck out of people. To the point, they left. He called them. The dogs left. Guess what, man? They fucking came back, and what did he do? Nothing, man. To the point, around my bag, I always, bear spray goes on one side. I had my fucking buck knife out, in my hand. And I got the fucking, I had the tripod, or my camera was inside my vest. And I had the monopod, which you're standing on right now, in this hand. And I'm fucking trying to get this fucking dog off me. I said, fuck this, I pulled my knife, and I'm just ready to fucking, this dog's coming, I'm just gonna fucking come right in here, eh? Fuck those kind of people, man. And that's all I gotta say about that. Anyways, we got a nice little soft spot here, I'll come pick you up. Fuck those people. Your fucking dogs be on a leash. Fucking bullshit. Anyways, I figure I got a nice flat spot right here. I'm going to set the tent there. My fire pit. I'm not exactly sure where the fire pit's going to go just yet. But, it's going to be away from the tent. In the most wind sheltered spot. Oh, hey, I'm over here. Guys, look, I'm over here, man. I want the fire pit to be in a very wind protected spot. I don't want fucking sparks and shit fucking going anywhere. I want maintained, as you can see. I mean, I'll give you a tour around in a little bit, but right now I want to get camp set up. What time is it here anyways? Let's have a look. The one problem is that I got a train bridge right up here, and Winnipeg's a big shipping yard for trains. We have several huge switch yards. It's 3:02. So I hit my mark. That's where I wanted to get to by 3:00. And we got a couple mountain bikers on the trail, which is awesome. I love people that are outdoors, man. I love get out, stay out, man. That's the whole thing, right? Okay, so yeah, I'm going to start pitching. According to people that I've talked to on the way, some really nice people that are just out enjoying, you know, it's a beautiful day, beautiful temperature. It looks so pretty with all the hoarfrost and the trees and stuff. So there's a few people out, and I like that. According to them, this is Crown Land. They live right here in the neighborhood. Actually, apparently, they live in one of those houses just across there. If you can see that, I'm not sure. But there are houses across there. Hence the stealth part of the camping mission. Not really that stealthy, is it? But who cares? I'm out, right? We can do some other... I've stealth camped behind a garbage can at Walmart before. Where was that? Saskatoon or something like that. Or Regina, maybe. I know it was in the Skatch. It was in the Gap. You know what the Gap is, right? It's an area of land that connects Alberta to Manitoba. I'm sorry, Saskatchewan. I'm just kidding. Yeah, I made my mark, 3:00. It's time to get shit set up. It's time to get the wood's not gonna be a problem, but I don't know how long this battery's gonna last. It's probably almost frozen. Now I'm not taking. Just let me adjust you here just a little bit. I'm not gonna take and kick all the snow away from my tent area. I do want to find this kind of stuff, and we'll use them towards the fire. That like to stick to you. I want to keep the snow underneath my tent as an insulator. I also don't want something ripping through my tent. But when you can feel how the ground is, and then when you feel something's different, you just have a look, that's all. Oh, I stubbed my toe. Time for a cigarette. Basically all I need to do. Okay, let's get into Monster. Like I say, this bag is old, man. I love this bag. I just absolutely love this bag. Now, next time, instead of carrying so much water, I'm just gonna bring my fucking water filter pump. I do use a pump. I'm not one of those Sawyer squeezes. What do you call them ones where you hang them in the fucking tree and stuff? I'm not that fucking lazy. You know, I'm out here to be active. I'm out here to get the heart going, get the lungs working, you know, enjoy. Okay. My North Face, you've all seen that before. Now, I am going to start layering up in a little bit. But right now, I'm still being pretty active, and I don't really think that's required just yet. Hoodie. My Columbia Heavy Fleece. Branch is making a fool of me. Camera gear, water, because I somehow lost all my water containers. Orville Redenbacher was doing the trick today. I wasn't sure how good it was. When I first left, I had this full right to the freaking top, and that was an extra 10 pounds. What am I doing, man? Fuck. Catch a grip. Odds and ends assortments, we'll get through that later. Have the coffee, man. God, I'm happy. Now, who the fuck said you could do that? If you don't stand up, I'm gonna have to stand you up, man. Fine, I'll do it all. Up you go. Let's go. Come on, fuck up, you know, bastard. Yeah, the hood, the brain they call it, in case anybody didn't know that, this is the brain of your pack. Underneath is my rain pants, my rain jacket. Inside is a sandwich, which is probably smashed to shit by now. Hat, extra set of gloves. Most importantly is my first aid kit. Oh, and I also carry my my condom for the bag, you know, in case it starts raining. But most important, this is where my first aid kit is at all fucking times. Why would I bury my first aid kit halfway down my bag? Something happens, I need my fucking first aid kit. What? Are you gonna start dumping bag and whatever? It doesn't make sense to me at all. So it's right there on top, always handy. Now, because I was carrying the water inside the bag like that in a jug, it wasn't approved by me. I had the plastic bag folded over. But the best way to keep your gear dry, 45 cents at Home Depot, man. Just go get a contractor bag. This is why my bag is so big. I was doing the stealth thing. These pads could easily go there. For the weight of them, I carry two. One's a sit pad. I use them both to sleep on. Next is my kitchen. We'll get into that, obviously. Fuel, of course. Why not carry the largest one I can get? Tent, Hubba Hubba NX. And I brought the whole tent. I'm not going to use the whole tent. And I'll show you after. Brooks bag are the bomb. MEC Brooks bags. They are indestructible. They're so thick. They are heavy. They're not like the North 49 dry sack 8 liter. But these things will take a shit kick in them. Trust me. They do. That's all my sleep clothes, by the way. Jock pants, socks, shirt, a fleece sweater, and an extra cap. Thermarest, obviously we all know what a thermarest is. What is in this? Oh, food. Oh, I got some squirrels. Mini bears. I love how Andrew Skirka says that, the mini bears. Raccoons, squirrels, moles, voles, shit like that. So, we'll have to make sure that I keep the crumbs at bay. And then, lastly, down here is my sleeping bag. In here, this camera equipment. Did you know that bananas are good for heartburn? I don't know if that's scientific. I haven't been able to prove it myself. Well, I do have heartburn from that Tang. Power food. Listen to this. 100 calories a cup. With the sugars. 12 fucking grams of sugar. And how much is one of these little cups? 92 gram cup. And out of the 92 grams, 12 grams of sugar. Percent calcium, 18 grams, 6% carbs. Grams of fat. Power food, man. Snack pack puddings. definitely clears. The reason why I'm always wearing something on my eyes, night or in dark, actually probably even now I could get away with these, or my darks, is honestly, I have two sets of balls, and neither set likes the fucking cold wind blowing in them. It's true, man. Banana peels, I don't consider that littering. Everything else, though, is leave no trace. Even waiting to see that in the morning, you'll go, fuck, you know, nobody even stayed there. Power cords and notebooks and eyeglasses. And this guy, hilarious. I'm going to try him out. I found him in at the bus stop. There's nobody around the bus stop. And obviously it wasn't used for crime, or I wouldn't have left it there. It was still in the package. The package was not opened at all. It's a survival hatchet. It has string. If it was worth anything, this would be $5.50. It has a can opener. It has three wrenches. I don't know what this fucking kind of survival dude is doing, but I think it's a piece of shit, to be honest with you. But we are gonna fucking play with it just to see what it does. Who knows? Some things have surprised me before. Alright, let's get to the tent. Whoa. I know what I wanted to see what was in here. Extra camera shit. Fuck. I was hoping I brought my belt with me. Because I don't like wearing a belt with a heavy bag. Because the bag sits on the belt grinds into your goddamn hip bones, and it just sucks. But I suppose I should put stuff back in here and do this up. Things first. You gotta get these fucking pants to stay up. So when I'm ready for the tent, I'll tune you back in, but right now I just need to take care of the things that are annoying me. You know what I mean? Okay, back with you now. Oh, a couple pinched nerves in my back. Walking with the backpack, surprisingly, makes it feel so much better. Yeah, and it was time for a smoke. This is smoke number two of the day, right after about 3:30 in the afternoon. Pretty pleased. As you can see, I deemed it time to layer up a bit. And so that's exactly what I did. We got some excellent little bit of small wildlife around here. We got some jays, we got some chickadees, we got squirrels running around. And in the background for ambiance, we have cars driving down the road. Whatever, man. Little chickadee there, right, just right behind the camera, man. He's just a fun little thing. Just always busy, eh? Those chickadees, man. They're always so busy. There's a bunch of them around here. I like it. Anyways, let's get on with the tent. I brought the full tent. But I'm not going to use the full tent. I'm going to, the mesh part of the tent is going to be, left in the bag. We don't need it. I'm not worried about bugs, spiders, and shit like that. I will say, as a side note though, that you'd be surprised, because I use, the MSR, it uses the no-see-um mesh, which is a lot, it's not as porous as just a regular mesh mosquito netting. The no-see-um is, and you'd be surprised at actually how much warmth you can retain inside that mesh. I know so many times I've got out of the mesh and I'm like, Jesus, this doesn't seem like, I didn't realize it was this chilly out. And really, really surprised at the, and I don't even know how that's fucking possible. But, there's a lot of things I don't know. no, I'm Mr. Know-It-All. Anyways, let's get on with this. I got laid off from work. Great time of year for that to happen. So I'm conserve my money when it comes to cigarettes. A normal 20 pack of cigarettes goes frickin' stale by the time I'm around to smoking them. The full 20 of them. But I do like having a tailor-made cigarette. To conserve money, my favorite tobacco is number 7. I love number 7 cigarettes, but they're $20 a pack. I'm not spending fucking $20 a pack. When I do cowboy roll, I go and I buy a pouch of the number 7, and I just cowboy roll. Anyways, what the hell does that have to do with a tent, Davey? Jesus, man. Let's go. You guys out there, raise your hands, please, if you're familiar with the Hubba Hubba NX. No, not so much. A few of you? Yeah? Okay. Good. Good, good, good. This guy's got... I bought him last year, so he's got over 300... I bought him... about... just under a year and a half ago, this time. And I don't consider paper and tobacco to be, it's just like one raindrop and it's disintegrated. There's nothing left of a rolling paper, so I'm not worried. If it was a filtered cigarette, I'd be putting that filter in my pocket, trust me, I do. So this guy's got over 300 days on him. Oh my God, how are you gonna figure it all out? What are you doing, man? All one. Hey, get in there. The Hubba, the Hub, and the Hub, which makes it the Hubba Hubba. It's got two hubs on it. This is one end. Here's your middle. There we go. Tent pole. That's how I said pole. Essentially, that's what it is. Now, it is always suggested that you buy a footprint for your tent, because it saves the wear and tear. And I'm a firm believer in that, and I always have had a footprint for my tents. See him? That is a gorgeous woodpecker. This is where I wish I had my DSLR. But I burnt I lost it when I lost everything in my house fire. Look at him, isn't he gorgeous? Fucking lovely. Come on, go to work, big guy. Oh, there's another one over here somewhere. Oh, I see him. He's underneath the tree branch, right? The dead part in the middle. See, he just popped up on top. I don't know if you can see that. That's the mate. So you got male and female. This one here looks to be like the male. Shimmying up the side of the tree. Fucking awesome. Awesome. Now, where did I have you? Somewhere in here. Scaring them off. I'm of no threat to them. They know that. Anyway, for this setup, having the footprint is an absolute must. We got the camera in a good position to see all this. The 170 degree view. Set up here like this. Now we leave the mesh in there. Rain fly. Now, I don't know, this side, I got these are a little bit bent more than what the other side is, which is pretty good for the amount of days that this tent's been used. But I did a minus 36, and I'm not shitting you. Minus 36 degree camp out with this tent. Well, the wind picked up and this fabric was so cold that as you can see, I got my own homemade band-aid on there, which is part of a different tent that I had totally wore out. I mean, for so many years I'd been using this tent. But I took a piece of them and seam gripped. The rip closed and reinforced it with some more tenting. So after all the amount of times that I've used this tent so far, since I've had it, she's holding up like a jewel. I'm going to work with the wind and not against it. Little metal tab in here. We'll some things you just can't do with gloves on. much. Try to be a little more gentler in the cold weather. Because to be honest with you, this isn't a four-season tent. This is a three-season tent. But in my opinion, your three-season tent should be able to put up with what conditions are that I'm dealing with today. And if it can't do that, then it's a piece of shit. I don't want it, and it can fuck off. Now, we gotta stake it out. Man, those are beautiful woodpeckers, man. I don't know the name of them, though. You know, in Algonquin, I seen one of the ones that were like a real woody woodpecker, like a really... Try again, take two. In Algonquin, I seen, a woodpecker, just like the real woody woodpecker that you would see in the cartoon. Those suckers are huge, man. I had no clue what it was, and it flew right by me. I was doing a portage trip. Flew right by me. I was like, what in the Sam hell was that? And it landed on a tree about 20 feet behind me. Whack, whack, whack. And I was like, I was impressed. I was thankful that day that I wasn't a woodpecker, because I don't know how you could live with a headache that big, but... Okay, six stakes. And we just go around. And this is when you find out exactly how frozen... You find out exactly how frozen... Get them all the way in. I mean, they got a little... Helps if I can grab one. I took the fucking string off my other camera because it was pissing me off, and now it's fucking pissing me off again. Okay, so they got this little hook there. So you get it in on an angle. And even if it happens to slide up, it's going to get trapped into that hook. You know what I'm saying? Now, I put one in the front corner. I'm going to put one in the rear corner. Pull it diagonally. It doesn't have to be extremely taut. That little survival hatchet. Let's see if it can at least pound a steak. Probably not, because it's got fuck all the head on it. Hey, you know what? I'm thinking that this fucking can opener part might be able to pull out the tent stakes in the morning. That would be alright. I'd like to see in here and see what my tent floor looks like. That's good enough. And corner number four. And it helps if you don't have dirt. When you have dirt already on there, kind of like an obstruction of pushing it in to the frozen dirt. So that thing's a piece of shit. Oh, fuck. good enough for that, you know. Zip that up. I'm gonna go around and tighten my fly. This is done easily. And all I wanna do is try to make sure that my lines are all matching up. So I think, all right, well, I guess my battery died, so I had to replace the battery. My bad, sorry about that. Okay. Now, back to what we were doing. And I'm dawdling here. If there was like a bad storm, or it was raining, or whatever, trust me, this would have been done. Fuck. Because there's nothing to it. Guy here, what I like to do is this is my pole. So instead of having this like this, in case I want to pull some, I don't want my, I'm walking around here all the time. I just find it better, safer for the equipment as well as for myself, is just keep it in there just a little bit. This thing slides off of there one more time and hits my finger, I'm gonna be saying, what do you mean, fuck the gloves, right? What a joke, man. Holy. I'm just gonna pop it on the backside. I'm gonna tag that out. Crooked one. Don't worry. Cold aluminum in your mouth in the wintertime is not a good idea, but I'm a trained professional. Do not try these stunts at home. Thank you. videos to show that I'm human too, by putting the tent too close to the log, so I can't butter in my last peg. And that's not a big deal, unless of course the log is frozen to the ground. But with brute strength and determination, it doesn't matter. Okay, let's try this again. And of course, why don't I just go ahead and step on that. So, we'll put a marker there to remind me. Alright. Definitely my head's going this way. You know that if you sleep with your head downhill, you will wake up with a fucking headache like you wouldn't believe. Okay, and that's the basis of my shelter for the night. Let's finish off by and then it's ready, and then we're ready to get a bonfire started. Woohoo! Sit by the fire, nice and toasty, warm. I'm glad I'm in here for the wind protection, which is pretty decent. Now I am going to be taking one of these out, and I use it as a sit pad. If you haven't noticed, my ass isn't all that big and fat, so. Next up is the Therm-a-Rust. So simple. This is a self-inflating pad. It's not going to really self-inflate in this kind of weather. You just open the valve and roll the sucker out. So between having the foam pad down as an insulation block, because you don't want to lose body heat convecting, or it's not convection, but yeah, having the cold air rob it from you, or the cold ground. So between having the foam pads, self-inflating mattress, I might have, I don't know, maybe about, as an insulation rating, maybe about 8. I would say probably about 8 with this setup. I have in there. I could have a dance party, for Christ's sakes. Hey! last but not least, the sweetened egg. Now, this is a Eureka bag. I don't have a Eureka sleeping bag, but I do have the stuff sack, which I put this bag in. Or when I'm using a different bag in summer, I don't need a bag that's as warm as this. I use this as my food bag to hang in the trees. I'd like to get an earth sack, but fuck, where's the money come from, right? So, this bag is a Mountain Equipment Co-op bag. Don't ask me what the temperature reading is, because I don't fucking know. I lost 7 sleeping bags when my house burnt. Well, my apartment. I had 2 apartments. Right by each. I was actually... this lady moved out. Her name was Pam. And I went in to clean her disgusting mess. And it sat vacant for a couple of weeks, so I just said I was running my own business and I was doing my own show, and I needed a storage place for my tools and materials and stuff, so I rented the apartment right beside mine. And in hindsight, you know how that's 2020. What a fucking horrible idea. But, you know, if somebody was going to break in, I'd want to hear them, you know. At the time, it made 110% perfect sense at the time. What I'll do with this is the clothes that I'm wearing tonight, I will put in here, and this will form my pillow. And my pillow will be about like this, maybe, because I don't really like pillows. This is a mummy style bag. For anybody that's not familiar with a mummy style bag, this is a mummy style bag. There's not a lot of extra air space in there, so your body doesn't have to spend that extra calories in trying to warm that extra space up for no freaking reason. And if you want, you can get this right over your head, and all you have sticking out is your face. Whatever you do, people, don't put your face inside your sleeping bag, because all your air that you breathe coming out of your mouth or your nose is going to get your bag wet, and you're going to suffer. That's all I'm going to say. Okay. This bag, by the way, I should note, this bag is not a down bag. I don't own a down bag. I have never in my life owned a down bag. Not that I don't want to, but even in wintertime there's 100% humidity, and down is going to suck that up like there's no tomorrow. The one bag that I would like to try is synthetic on the bottom. Because when you squish down, it loses its insulation value. So they have bags out now where the top of the bag is down and the bottom is synthetic. That is something I would be interested in trying. Looking into. I am looking into it, actually. But for me, I want to meet somebody that has actually slept in one. Until then, I will not proceed with spending that money, that kind of you're talking like $500-$600 for a sleeping bag. I'm not putting out that kind of cash unless I know that somebody will say, yep, I'd love it. Until then, fat chance, man. Fat fucking chance. Okay. Until I'm ready for my pillow. I like organization in my camp. And I'll tell you why. Gear is expensive. gear is very, very expensive. Top quality gear is very fucking expensive. And I'm in the snow. So, a little lackadaisical, oh, yeah, I'll get it later. Oh, no, you know what? It's gone. You'll never see it again. You'll wonder what happened to it for your next outing, like my saw. The first piece of equipment I've lost in, fuck, 15 years, man. But it happens. It happens, you know? So, all right, I'm going to bring the rest of the gear over. I'm going to set up shop. And I'll tune you back in when I figure out about a fire and what's going to happen with that stuff. Okay. Okay, guys, I just took a second here to turn up the exposure on the camera. Because it's 4:30 in the afternoon and it's dark. It's getting real dark. Too dark to shoot right now. That's why I had to turn up the exposure values. I'm putting in a fire pit over here. I got some beautiful oak wood, man. Oh, woo! And, yeah, so we're gonna clean this up a little bit better, and, I'll put a couple, if I can get a couple logs that I can, split them and put them down there in half. I'm not gonna have a very big fire. I never do have very big fires. But I want to make sure that if the wind does pick up, it's not blowing ash on my tent. Other than that, a little ash blowing somewhere in here. I mean, everything is so damp, wet, and covered in snow. I still don't want to take chances. So I keep my fire small. If the weather does turn, the wind picks up, I just put out my fire. The best thing about campfires in winter is there's no shortage of water to put them out. So anyways, I'm going to hurry up and get some more firewood, because what I wanted to do today was use a magnesium bar with the striker on the back and some cotton balls and Vaseline. So I'm gonna, even if I'm just trying to get to the point where I can catch that on film. And I need to get my headlamp out, because the last thing you want to do is look for your headlamp when it's already freaking dark out. So, okay, I'll be back with you. Okay, guys, I turned the exposure all the way up, as far as I can go. It's pretty much dark. I'm behind. You ever heard that expression? You screwed the pooch? I fucking screwed the pooch. And I don't mean I'm slack at work making pups. I screwed the pooch. What I should have done, I know there's hoarfrost covering everything. And that means everything is freaking soaking wet. So I'm going to cheat. I'm going to, I'll just show you. Let me strap the headlight on so that I can give us extra light. And let's see how I can make out here. Maybe I didn't screw the pooch. Maybe if all of a sudden you found yourself in this situation, what do I have at hand to start a fire and save my ass? How about we just look at it like that? Saves me from looking like a freaking jackass, doesn't it? All right, I'm going to roll with that one. So what I got, let me get my headlamp on here. Safety glasses, don't need my clear. Fuck. Why is it when you try to hurry, you actually are slowing yourself down? Does anybody agree with that? Okay, maybe that'll help. So, I know in my food, I have pudding. So I'm going to take the cardboard from the pudding, and that's going to be my base. Is it snowing? It is snowing. It's fucking snowing. That's awesome. Okay, and I'm also going to take this cardboard, I'm just going to kind of try to make like a little bit of kindling out of it, or tinder, I guess I should say. Can't even tear the shit. Everything is absolutely soaked. Soaked. This guy's gotta get out of my way because he's driving me crazy here. And I need my knife out anyways. I tried looking under logs, tried looking anywhere that the wind might not blow and the moisture not get, but you know what, man, we're in Canada. Like, useless thought, man, a useless thought. Just more edges to catch fire, you know, instead of just catching on one edge and all that bullshit. Okay. What the hell, man? What is this cardboard made out of? Kevlar? Okay. What I know I also have is you never leave home without some shit ticks. So we're gonna stick a couple of these in around here. Rip this shit up. Let's do this again. Scoop this stuff up. Put it in my hand. Drop that down. Drop this down. I didn't have time to find any wood to lay down on here or nothing. Now, what I also know is always in my backpack. Always is in my backpack. Is a magnesium with the striker. It's bouncing everywhere. That I don't want it to go. See if we can hit a couple of that. Okay. Oh! Stop! Hold the presses. Hold the presses. It's not what I wanted to do at all. I wanted the magnesium, yes. That's not what I wanted. Where is it? Here we go. This was today's lesson. Cotton balls with petroleum jelly. Vaseline. Let's try one of these bad boys. Let's see how that works now. And we will not use any more magnesium. We're just going to try striking it. Those are my smallest ones here. This is where I do want to just kind of pick out something small. But everything is so wet. Oh, I have to try. Why did that go out? That Vaseline. I think I'm going to be in luck on this one. Okay, maybe. Time to get some more twigs ready. not too shabby. Not too shabby. It's not going yet though. Don't full summit yourself. You'll notice that I'm going a little thicker, not by very much. I'm still putting in the same size ones that I kind of started with at the same time. But you want to introduce the ones that are getting just a little bit thicker around, a little bit bigger diameter. You know what I'm saying? Of course you know what I'm saying. You guys are pros at this, man. It's good to have you guys along, man. This is fun. I'm having a real good time here today. Now my objective, my goal, what I kind of want to see happen here is I maintain basically the same circumference of fucking fire that it is now. Now I know that it's going to spread out to about here. I know that. But I also know that by being careful, being conservative, woo! Remember, I'm wearing synthetics. We gotta be careful. by being conservative, because in the morning I'm gonna leave no trace. So I don't want to leave a bunch of burnt up ground behind for the next hiker to come. There we go. You find yourself with a little tiny piece of cardboard up your pudding. You know that you got some tissue or toilet paper in the glove compartment of your car. Let's say you broke down. Go ahead and get yourself a fire started. Don't be afraid to get out of your car and save your life. Your car doesn't run and it's wintertime. Get out, get shelter. Here you go, guys. Here you go. I gotta keep working on this fire. And I let you guys kick back and enjoy it for a bit. Like I said, don't count your chickens before they hatch. Because by no means is this something to be relied on right now. That's why I gotta work at it. I'm finding the deadest wood that I can that's not punky. I don't like punky wood. It doesn't burn. Well, it does burn, but it doesn't burn right. It sends off a lot of smoke. It sends off a horrible stinking smell. This baby to coax itself back to life here. If you can see here in the light, this piece of wood just laying there. Now I looked at it and I thought, well, that looks a little suspect. I took that little axe, I drove it in there, I cut this in half. I was actually surprised that that little fucker worked as good as it did. But you can see how nice that wood is. It's this is what you're looking for. Smoke in the eyes. I don't know, you guys gonna be able to see me. Beautiful. Real quick before I gotta dive more wood on here. I'll dive some more wood on first. Gotta love this oak. The camera you guys are watching me through, it's got twin stereo microphones on it. This wood's wet. It's silent. There's no smoke. It's just... what a beautiful little fire, man. Gorgeous. Anyways, let's have a little recap on the day. What happened today? I got up this morning. And trust me, guys, I would much rather be at work than out here doing this. Because, something about me. I just have this thing for working. I love being at work. My second love, well, here we are. Catch, look at that. And maybe you can see me like that. Like this? I don't know what's even better. Maybe you can't even see me at all. I don't know. So we got out this morning and we did the walk. showing off the hoarfrost. Just beautiful. And decided I couldn't leave it at that. I just couldn't leave it at that. So, packed the bag, got the gear, I got some food I can cook. I'm actually gonna put the pot on the fire when I get a little bit of coals and whatever. And I don't know what I'm gonna do. I got rice and I got ramen. I got a big thick ham sandwich. Cheese on it, so it's not really going to be hurting for food tonight, but yeah, so we packed the bag. I had some barbecue meatballs with rice and vegetables for my noontime dinner, and threw the bag on, and it probably was about, in total, 12 kilometers to get here, and that's probably being a little bit conservative, and that's fine. Point is that, got out, we're taking advantage, you know, we're taking advantage of such beautiful night. It's cold, I mean, you can probably see my breath. Sitting by the fire, I'm sitting on my gloves, because I found this log, and I thought that was decent to sit on, and set up camp, got the fire going, and it's not even 5 o'clock at night yet, and look how dark it is. I mean, that exposure on that camera's turned all the way up, but I'm comfortable. More than that, I'm happy. Happiness goes a long way. There's nothing wrong with winter camping, guys. Pick your days. Weekends, try to plan for a weekend that if you're just thinking about getting into doing some winter camping, just think it through, you know. What am I going to eat? What am I going to drink? I got to be hydrated. What am I going to wear? What's the temperature going to be? What's the precipitation forecast going to be? And make your decision. Try to go on like a warmer night, you know. I'd say anybody should be comfortable minus 10 and warmer. When you start passing the minus 10, you need a bit of different skill set. But get out and try, man. You know, like, even if I wanted to, it's 5 o'clock at night. To walk 12 kilometers back home because shit's just not going my way is nothing. It's nothing. So what if I don't even go home till 10 o'clock tonight? Who cares? I'm not out freezing my ass and, you know, there's Crown Land everywhere. I'm on Crown Land. There's nobody gonna come kick me off of here. I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm not, you know. The only thing I am doing wrong is I got no beverage. But I do got coffee. Point is just get out and try. Get out and explore. Do something new. See something that's pretty. You know, winter is such a pretty time of year. And, like yesterday, I seen a view of the, of that, old, shit, and I don't remember what it's called. But anyways, I was able to take advantage of the frozen ice, to get a different view, a different perspective of something I'd seen only on one perspective of. So it's a great opportunity to get out and explore, do some snowshoeing or some cross-country skiing, you know, the stuff, and what does it cost me to be out here? It cost me some time, I gotta eat anyways, it's costing me absolutely zero to be out here. Zero. You know? So, I don't know. Think about it. Because the only one that's going to benefit out of it is you. And what a great thing. So, for now, I'm going to... I think I'm going to go and snack on them two puddings that I just burnt up the box from. And make sure camp is good. Make sure to take a quick sweep. Bring in a little bit more wood. And I'll probably just end up calling this the end of the night. Unless I think of something else, you know? Who knows? So, for now... Letter Tramp says, have yourselves a great evening, have a great night, and see you in the morning.
Oops. Where are you, man? Where are you? Morning. I dropped you already. Sorry. Awesome. What a great sleep. It's, I just got out for a pee. 6:13, I opened my eyes. Yeah, this is me, first thing in the morning, I know. Look away, man, I'm hideous. Snowed last night. That's awesome. I just got to hear this wet snow. Not like big flake. It was more like, little pellet kind of snow. Hard, crystally hitting the tent all night. But what I also did was it just killed maybe I should just get a coffee on first, eh, before I start talking. It killed my ventilation. Check out, can you see that moisture? I don't know if you can see the moisture on there or not. This whole tent is just covered in moisture. And, because the snow kept sliding down. So, we're... I seem to be having some technical difficulties this morning, guys. Okay. Anyways. It's enough of looking at me. If you can even see me. I got sleepers going on. I must just look like a freaking wreck, man. But I'm telling you, what a bomb sleep, man. I didn't wake up at all last night. So when I went to bed. And, you know, I've got more layers back on because I had to get out for pee. But that's doing it right. All right. I'm going to just ask you to hold tight here for a second. But my sciatic nerve, holy fuck, does it hurt? Jesus Christ, does it hurt? I'll get into that in a second. I'm gonna get you guys up here, aren't you? Tripod. Hold on a second. Man, the decisions I make before coffee and a cigarette in the morning, I don't know, don't trust me. Certainly I wouldn't want me selling my own house before coffee and a cigarette. That's for sure. Great, there goes my alarm. Up before the alarm, that's fucking bomb. 6:30 a.m. You can see that. Up before the alarm, I fucking love it. All these people that say, oh, don't be cooking in your tent and shit like that, those people can fuck off too. Okay, see how I keep the booties inside the sleeping bag? Yeah, even my socks are orange and black. So I got some wood chips in here from yesterday. What I'm looking for is my fuel canister. I sleep with it in here too. There it is. You know, it's just like that butane lighter situation that I was talking about whenever I was talking about it, if you guys were listening or paying attention. Same thing, keep the butane warm and she works much better, especially if you're relying on it to eat. Jesus Christ, this is... Oh, son of a... does that hurt? You motherfucker. Son of a bitch, that hurts. First things first, let's get the water on, eh? Kitchen. All this stuff fits in my pot. This is my pot cozy. You got a scrubber for cleaning up. We got a little bit of biodegradable soap. We got the stove itself. We got a spoon. And we got a measuring cup, which is a half cup measuring cup. And any other gradients of water that I need. My Nalgene bottle has increments on it as well, so. Okay. You'll see this. Look, I don't know, I'm having a hard time with my fucking hands in this fucking camera this morning, man. It's pissing me off right now. I always cook in my tent. With the fly on, with the fly off, I don't give a fuck. I always cook in my tent. I don't... If you know what you're doing, you pay attention to what the fuck you're doing in life. You hear that snow falling down? I didn't even take that snow off of there this morning. I took some pictures, some still pictures of it when I got out to pee, but she's gonna warm up in here anyway, so. And that's another good reason why I like to cook in my tent. You get that extra warmth first thing in the morning. My stove, it's the MSR Pocket Rocket 2. I carry, and don't laugh at me, but I carry a can opener. And, of course, a big lighter. Alright. One of these got to go first. Okay, there we go. And where's the other one? That's the stove, man. Oh, make sure that's off. Okay. I'm not one to waste fuel, so we'll get this kind of set up here a little bit. So my first task is coffee. See, there's ice in here. Now, I did bury my water bottle upside down last night. We'll go take a look at that in a little bit. Can see that, I'm not sure. Ready for the jet? It's just to show you. Okay, so we're up, we peed, the alarm went off, we got water on, where's the lid? We got ice in there, and that's why I sleep with my fuel can down by my feet, because it wouldn't work like this in these temperatures, as well as this. Put this stuff back in the pot. This is a pot cozy. I always boil about a whole pot of water. And this is the Pinnacle Soloist, so it's only, I don't remember what this is. 750 maybe? But you can look it up if you want. It's the Soloist. I've had to take a clamp and push the two rivets back together because the handle's coming loose and the fucking water's dripping out. Fucking piece of shit. Okay. But this pot cozy, so I pour my coffee and there's still water. Well, or if I'm cooking or something, I take the pot and there's a spot here for the handle. You drop the pot back in here, and it'll keep the water nice and keep the water hot. Or if you have rice or noodles, you don't have to keep the stove cooking, boiling that fucking shit. You, as soon as it comes to a boil, you fucking stir it up. You put it in your pot cozy, and you wait for the 7 or 8, 9, 10 minutes, whatever the directions call for. And you save a lot of fucking fuel, a lot of fuel, man. I fell asleep last night reading Snow Walker, Farley Mowat. What a great old book, man. I gotta be careful with these books, man, when I'm backpacking, because they tend to get a little bit. October of 1973. I was 2 years old. Awesome. Good read, man. Good read. It's good to... I haven't read that book in holy jumping for so long. It was nice. Alright, well this has been excellent trip, man. Excellent trip. We had the hoarfrost, and we come out here and camp up, and snow last night, and I slept like a fucking baby all night long. Just beautiful, great sleep. I'm up before the alarm. Got some water on the boil. Get some coffee going. Usually I can wait longer than this to have a cigarette, but this is more like a congratulatory morning cigarette. I told you before, man, smokers don't need any fucking reason to have a cigarette. Everything's an excuse for a cigarette. Everything. Wow, I slept good. I better have a cigarette. Oh, shit, man. Awesome. Yeah, that's fucking... I don't care who you are. That is fucking funny shit. Man, I'm celebrating the fact I had a good sleep. Like, cranking out a fucking early morning smoke. That's awesome. Well, I guess we could check on how our water's doing. Oh, can you see the steam coming out of there? Not bad, not bad, not yet, but not bad. Love my morning coffee. Camp coffee, ugh, there's nothing like it, man. Tim Hortons, piss off. You don't even know what good coffee is. Come winter camping. Get up and you get out of your tent and you fuck, that cold air hits you because you're out of your sleeping bag. You do what you got to do first thing in the morning, you get back in, you get your water going. That is a fucking good cup of coffee. I don't care what anybody says. Starbucks, fuck, can't hold a candle on my coffee, baby. Not even close. Okay, where's the goods? Where's the food bag? Now let's have a look and see what we got for breakfast. We got a couple more noodles, Mr. Noodles. Got another thing of rice in here. Looks like I got some honey and brown sugar and apple and spice oatmeal. Works for me. I need a filter. Pretty happy with the amount of battery that I used for my headlamp last night. Anytime you're out winter camping and it's dark at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, you're going to use a lot of battery power. And I'm pretty tickled. On my usage last night. It's all things I evaluate myself on. Kind of like in my head or whatever, like how was my, I call it my PR, my performance rating. What's my performance rating for this trip? All in all, I haven't got out of here yet. But all in all, I'd say fucking pretty damn good, man. I'm pretty happy with, I'd say maybe a 8.5 to 9 for sure. The kindling I could have collected throughout the day as I was walking, and put it into an inside jacket pocket. That would have helped dry it. That for sure would have raised my PR, and I am taking that into account. So nice fucking flat spot to sleep on, which is important. Out of the wind, which is important. Not down where all the cold air is, which is important. I'm gonna give myself an 8.5 thus far. I carried water, and I guess in hindsight, I'm glad that I did. So, well, and I knew, I mean, I carried the water, so that was my decision to carry the water. So I guess I had thought that through enough where I figured the rivers would be frozen. All right, morning smoke. Okay, that water's hot enough for this kid. Now I'll show you what I mean about the pot cozy. Take the pot and drop it inside the cozy, like such. I guess I better not do that right on top of my sleeping bag, just in case. Then you take your lid, and I got this lid designed specifically for a certain direction. Towards the handle. And there you go. And all that, this stuff, it's called Reflectix. What it is bubble wrap with kind of like a tinfoil attached on both sides, sandwiching the bubble wrap. It's a great insulator for doing stuff like this. And as you can clearly see, I have no worries. I've used this before. I have no worries of anything melting because of the hot pot or anything like that. So it's all good, baby. She's good in the hood. Okay. Now, big spoon. I forgot the sleeping bag has got some little nicks, tears, or this looks like it's melted at some point. This bag was given to me when I lost everything in my house fire, well, my apartment fires, and I don't know the rating on it. I know it's not as warm as I have a Edmund Hillary bag. I think that was bought at Sears or something a long time ago. I've had it for so long, and I was lucky that it was over. My buddy borrowed it, and I was lucky that I still have that one. Okay, where's my mug? There it is. My gallon jugger. Trip, and I knew that I had coffee, sugar twins, and creamer. Call that creamer? The good stuff. Coffee mate. But this coffee bag, I forgot, has got a slight hole in it somewhere. So I stuck it inside my original Oreos. What a good snack. Awesome snack. I love Oreo snacks. Okay, we don't need that fucking much. One big fucking heaping spoon. Get that in there. Come to this guy. I don't want white powder all over everything. It'd probably look pretty suspect. So I double bagged this one. I'm gonna put out my cigarette halfway because it's all I can smoke. Half a cigarette. Well, let me get two of these guys in there. And I'm gonna put eight of these guys in there. This isn't just your regular, you know, cup of coffee you sit down to breakfast with. This baby's my mojo, man. That was three. This is six. This is the morning. This is my every morning. In a tent. Notice how I'm still in my sleeping bag. I got some layers on, but keeping my feet, most of my legs are still in my bag. I've been known, excuse me, when you try quitting smoking, there's so much phlegm comes out of your lungs sometimes. It sucks. Okay, here we go. I actually put nine in. Now, D's. What I normally do, and I hate myself for doing it the next time, but I just throw them right back in there. Because I don't care. I'm not leaving my garbage laying around. That's the important thing. Leave no trace, guys. Leave no fucking trace. Which means I got a little bit of work to do with my fire pit today, but that's okay. Okay. Now, back to the pot cozy. Woohoo! Now, that water that's in there is left. Hiding. Fucking voila, what a fucking perfect cup of coffee this morning. Alright. Well, you don't got a dick and fuck around with your coffee in the morning to get it tasting good. You do it right the first time. You know what, man? You just know that you're off to a good start on your fucking day. Excellent. Okay, double bag this fucker up again. Take the air out, saves room. Room is very important to a backpacker, by the way. When you load your backpack, and I'll show you loading my backpack, it's like you're trying to pour concrete in there. You want to fill every little tiny space. You know what I'm saying? Let's get this lid on here and keep our heat in. I guess I could have cleaned it off a bit, but fuck it, I don't care. Now, I used to have a plastic bowl that used to fit in here, but it got cold and I kneeled on it by accident one day and it fucking shattered. So while the water's hot, let's see how many we got of each. One, two, three. One, two, three. I think I'm going to go with brown sugar. Maple and brown sugar. A perfect Canadian breakfast. And well, we're gonna eat right out of the pot. Normally what I do, to be honest with you, is I do this. Pour the water in there. Take the spoon. Saves on dishes. But I'm not caring about that today. We're gonna just dump all this stuff right in here. See if we can fit a third one in here. It's actually kind of the way I like it right there, but we're going to dump the third one in anyways. Okay, guys. Voila. My breakfast, my coffee's made. I'm going to turn you off so I can sit back and enjoy. And when I start packing up, man, I'm going to turn you guys back on. Right now, I'm going to try to charge up this battery a little bit. Look at that goodness. Coffee of this size and three packs of oatmeal. One pot of coffee, one pot of water I had to boil. And that was it. What a beautiful day it's starting out to be. Alright guys, I'm going to catch up with you in a little bit. I'm going to enjoy my breakfast. Hey guys, was talking about that water bottle situation. Sky's coming up beautiful over there. I don't know if you can see that. But the water bottle, turning it upside down, burying it in snow. Let's go have a look. There's my pile. As you can see, I walked around working on my tent, but as you can see, this mound is completely untouched. Fresh snow has fallen on it. Okay, what do we see? We got a tiny little bit of ice on the top. Yeah, we got a little bit of ice all the way around. I'm surprised, actually. Set you down here for a second. But the thing is, this. You can get your water. If you look at the bottom, it's completely frozen over. 100%, it's 110% completely frozen over. You wouldn't be able to pour the water out of this container had it been sitting upright.
Oh, the kid might know a thing or two. How about that? Woo!
All right, as you can see, I'm stripping down camp. Got Monster over there. Monster's not gonna be as big getting out of here as he was coming in. I promise you that. A little better packing. We're not worried about stealth shit, so yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna get back at it. My hands are freezing. They got the burning feeling going on, you know what I mean? All right. Okay guys, camp's packed up. Monster's over there. As you can see, he's not quite the size that he used to be because I got the sleep pads on the outside, the water jugs are on the outside. We're not doing the stealth thing where you don't give a shit. We already had company last night, so whatever. But the important thing is I have no garbage. I brushed over as best as I could my sleeping area. Fire pit area is over here. And what I did was I took all my ashes and I put them into a plastic bag and covered that over as best as we can. One more little sprinkling of snowman and nobody will ever have a fucking clue that I was here. And that's the whole thing. Leave only footprints. That's basically all I'm doing here, guys, is just leaving only footprints. And I'm proud of that. So. Okay, I'm going to get Monster loaded up, and then we're going to start our hike out of here. Of course, that train had to come by now. Just trying to look to see these chickadees up here. I don't know if you can see that. See them flipping around there? They're just, they're always so fun. They're always so active. Always singing and playing and... Man, they're like me, children for life. Anyway, guys, pack's loaded up. Still got coffee in hand, and it's time to get out of here. I was talking with a gentleman from across the river. He's out walking his dogs, real friendly guy. Pleasure to meet people like that, I love it. But I think this morning, I'm just going to shut my old pie hole here, and we'll enjoy the walk out together. Oh, there's a woodpecker up there in that tree. Just went behind there. There he goes. Beautiful. What a beautiful, beautiful place to have camped up last night. I tell you, something special down here.
Slipcurry. Shopping cart. Look at that, beautiful. Just that fresh powder that came down last night. You know what I gotta do? I gotta stop and change my settings. I forgot my, settings are turned way up for nighttime shooting. I'll be back. Okay, never mind. My exposure compensation was already readjusted to zero. I don't remember doing that. So now I'm wondering how my shooting last night and early this morning in my tent is gonna look. But I guess we'll find out soon enough. All right, get the snow off of here. Onward bound. Oh, this looks like a bit of a hill. I remember coming down about 30 kilometers an hour with the brakes on and just slid the whole way. I think I dumped all my water weight. What a fabulous place. A few people out walking their dogs this morning. It's good. It's good. I love it when I see people out. 5G kills fast, what? These trains are running across here pretty light. And I promise you, I know. I've ridden a lot of those suckers, man, and I don't know, it's just something about them that just sticks with me, you know? Can't ride those. Heck, those things don't even got a floor in them. Okay. Away we go. Glad I'm not the dumbass trying to push a shopping cart through the snow. There's another one of your outflow pipes. Oh, my alarm's going. So, I'll tell you what that means. It's 9 o'clock. Yes, sirree, Bob. 9 a.m. Leaving on a departure schedule as I had planned. I just lollygagged this morning. On purpose. Just enjoyed the morning. What the heck? There's big tires out there. Huh. Wonder what the significance of that is. You know, I probably could have went and camped up in here. Grabbed them chairs. Would have been all right. Well, I guess I'm going this way. Right. Left. Correct is left. Apparently those big fire rings that we seen yesterday are not locals and hooligan kids and shit like that. It's the fucking city doing it. They're coming down here and they're cutting out all the elms because of the Dutch elm disease. And yeah, they're the ones responsible for all those great big burn piles, man. Sad. I left my campfire pit with my ashes cleaned up, covered back over. Come spring, you won't even know it. As you see, when I kicked all that snow and debris out, there was just dirt. So it's not like I was burning up like a in the middle of a grass field or something, you know, I'm putting a burn ring in there. You'll never even know that I had a fire there. Looks like I guess there's some people living down here. I don't see no fresh footprints though. He's got a fucking chair. Yeah, my walking stick I'm working on. It's got the cool beaver chew. And my thumb fits it just fits so nice like this. I'm pretty tickled with it, to be honest with you. And I hope I wasn't supposed to strip off a layer or two before I started this. It's such a pain in the ass. But there's no room for laziness out here. If I start feeling warm, I'm telling you what, I'm stopping taking this pack off and then stripping down layers because hypothermia is no joke. Sun coming up. Size of these trees, man. Look at this. Look at the size of that guy. What a beautiful specimen of a tree. Cottonwood. Could you imagine? Like, look at the size of these trees, man. Could you imagine you're in Sequoia National Park out there in California? Man, they build roads through those suckers, man. I would just love to go and see that one day. Largest trees in the world. And I'm impressed with these. Fuck. I'll be walking around with a goddamn heart on. I was in that joint. Whew. That's pretty suspect, eh? You certainly wouldn't want to be putting your tent under that widowmaker. Christ. Look how thick this bark is. Look at that, eh? Huh. It's like armor. It's like I'm big and I'm tough. Can't fuck with me. I love it. Now, I bet you I could walk right across the river from here. But, there's no way in hell I am taking that chance this early in the year. Now, I've lost that 35 pounds of water weight, but I still got an extra, I don't know what I'd have on me right now. Probably about 42 pounds, maybe. Anyways, that extra, oh yeah, and I'm just a scrawny little shit-ass 168 pounds. 5'10". So an extra 42 pounds, extra 40 pounds. That puts me over the 200 mark. Yeah. It's not worth trying, especially I haven't done it without the pack, so. Get some squirrels here, see? Squirrel tracks. What do we got here? See this guy? This track here. Boop. That's a vole. It's like a little fucking kind of mouse rodent type of deal. A little vole. V-O-L-E. Got up here, and I do have my glasses on. Well, there's a dog on the loose around here somewhere, or I mean, we do got coyotes here in the city, we do got foxes. Oh, that's just that lightning struck tree. I thought it looked like a big piece of equipment or something. Deer prevalent right here in the city. Like when you're a major intersection of Main and Portage, traffic comes to a stop and animal control are called because there are deer in the middle of the intersection, which is 6 lanes by 6 lanes by 6 lanes. How can you not love that, man? How can you not love it? Animal attitude, man. There's something to be said about animal attitudes. Okay. Time to switch hands here. Stainless steel mug. Insulated, keeps the coffee hot, but outside sure stays cold. I'm telling you, man, I need such a perfect cup of coffee this morning. I just want to guzzle it down, but I'm afraid the next cup won't be as good, so I'm taking my time and enjoying. It's like somebody's riding one of them stupid fat bikes down the bank down there. I'm sorry, guys, but if you're a fat bike rider, I laugh at you. I can't help it, man. You know, those bikes are made for California, for riding on the sand, like Venice Beach, AKA Muscle Beach. That's where those bikes are invented for. And some idiot thought, ooh, look at that. Oh, mm-hmm. That's almost a good building log, man. Look at this, here. Oh, okay. They took it out of there. Huh. But, yeah, sorry to say, Dutch Elm disease is taking that one. Damn, man. You can tell by the bark. It's a shame. Yeah, so anyway, some jackass thought, hey man, fat bikes will work in the winter time in the snow. Guess what? They fucking don't. You don't want your bike, you're on two wheels for Christ's sakes, balancing act as it is. You don't want your bike riding on top of the snow. You want your tires to cut through. Winter time, I changed to a skinnier tire with spikes, man. I cut right through the snow. Grip right on whatever ice or road surface that I have, or off-road surface, and the day you catch me riding a fat bike is the day you catch me riding a fucking moped with a fat lady on the handlebars. Ain't happening. I gotta tell you, the temperature, surprisingly warm. I'd say it's probably -5, -7. With the wind, there is wind blowing. Little heavier than a breeze, but not true, like. So I'd probably say she's down around -12. Now I got all my layers on from yesterday. It's like this morning, right? And I got to camp, I layered up. Have you seen that? I got all those layers still on, and I'm comfortable. Huh. Well, I tell you, I'm in the city. Where do you be? Come on, these guys don't even know how to run a hot saw very well, do they? Holy fuck, buddy. It would just be a nice smooth cut, man. Oh well. Who am I to criticize? Yeah, we're gonna lose a layer when we get up here. For sure, we're losing a layer. I slept with outside in my sleeping bag. I slept I had my booties inside my sleeping bag, my fuel can inside my sleeping bag, my cameras, my batteries, everything inside my sleeping bag. And, but sometime in the middle of the night, I was laying, sleeping on my stomach. And, I had shifted down where my sleeping bag wasn't on top of my sleeping pad any longer. And, my toes are very susceptible to the cold right now because of freezing them last year. And, well, we got a lady with a dog. I'm going to give her a second here. She's going to leash him up. And I appreciate that. Especially because it's a poodle. And don't underestimate the fight in a fucking poodle. They are vicious. Good morning. Beautiful morning, isn't it? Awesome. That's a beautiful poodle you got there.
Thank you.
Yeah, enjoy your day. Thank you. Now, that's a lady I got a lot of respect for. She stops, she puts her dog on leash. When Susan passed, no doubt she's unleashing him again and letting him run. And that is good animal control.
has good respect for your fellow man. It's just good all the way around. Ah, yesterday, boy, that scared the fucking shit right out of me. Them dogs are big, man. When you're looking at a mastiff and a fucking, I don't know, the other one was a mix. I don't know what his breed was, but he was damn near as big as that fucking mastiff. And these things are fucking snapping and snarling and fucking biting on me. I've got my camera, my monopod. I'm fucking trying to keep that dog away from me. Yelling at the guy to call his dogs off. And I told him, I said, that's not fucking cool, bud. Oh, yeah, well, sorry, but, you know, they are friendly. Fucking friendly my ass, I said to him. That's my exact words. Fucking things are biting me, man. Fuck friendly. Anyways, I got no respect for those kind of fucking people. They can all fucking piss off and die. Ooh, isn't that a little harsh, Leather Champ? No, it's not. Stop breathing my air. I gotta stop here, man. I gotta lose a layer. A hay bale. What the hay bale's going on? Yeah, we gotta get rid of some layers here. I'm really surprised that I'm not hearing birds chirping. Not a bad set of work gloves, man. $10 at the Giant Tiger. Insulated. Comfy. Fit well. Pretty impressed. Okay, the vest I'm gonna keep, I think. So I leave my other cameras in there. But these guys gotta come off. That's my phone. Guess I'll take it out. Anybody want to see what a 9-year-old Samsung Galaxy Core looks like? All smashed to shit. Gets the job done. That's all I give a fuck about. Okay. Now, damn it, I need this hoodie off, so I'll be back, guys.